Hi guys, welcome back to another video. I have another tequila special cocktail for you today. You can probably tell that I quite enjoy a tequila-based cocktail at the moment, so expect more of them. Or if you don't, leave a comment if you don't like tequila cocktails in the comments below. And if you haven't already, give us a like and subscribe. It means a lot more than you would know. Thank you very much to everyone who's subscribed so far. If you haven't, what are you waiting for? Click the subscribe button and the bell icon as well. Get all those notifications. But yeah, we're gonna be making a lovely Paloma cocktail for you today. So quite similar to the classic margarita, which we made in a previous video. I'll get the link somewhere on the screen here for you, or will you put it down in the comment box? I don't know, it'll be around somewhere. So give that a view if you haven't already, if you like a margarita and you like tequila cocktails. But this one is chef kiss. Very, very tasty. We're gonna be using the same tequila as we used in the margarita video. So the phenomenal Ocho tequila. Very, very, very beautiful tequila. Very accessible and a very good price point as well. I think you can pick up a bottle on Master of Malt or Whiskey Exchange. I think about £24 a bottle for their standard Blanco and a little bit more for their Reposado. They're always out of stock because it just sells like hotcakes. Probably me in the restaurant buying like in 12 dozen cases at a time because it's just amazing. But yeah, that tequila we're gonna be using, it's phenomenal. We're also gonna be using Franklin & Sons Pink Grapefruit Soda. So a really nice, slightly zesty and bitter soda that's just gonna help make it a long cocktail. So really ideal for hot weathers. If you're having a few friends over for a garden party, maybe in the afternoon or late evening, these are really nice long cocktails to sip over ice or, you know, drink really quick, I don't know. But very, very tasty. Nonetheless, we're also going to be using some fresh pink grapefruit juice. If you don't want to use pink grapefruit juice, or sorry, should I say fresh pink grapefruit juice, feel free to substitute that with a supermarket bought carton. Try and opt for a juice that's already, or I guess a little bit more fresher, should I say, and that's in the fridge. I know like Tesco's and Sainsbury's have their cartons that are already in the fridge and not like the long shelf life stuff that's from concentrate. Try and use the fresher based stuff and it'll just make your cocktail 10 times better and you and your guests will appreciate it more. We're also gonna be using fresh citrus. What's wrong with me today? I'm just getting all words mixed up. I'm tired, it's hot, but yeah, show must go on. So we're gonna be using fresh lime juice. Lily said citrus again. Fresh lime juice that I squeezed earlier. So again, I've said it in multiple videos, squeeze your lime juice on the day. It will taste better in your cocktails and you'll lose acidity if you leave it in the fridge for a couple days at a time. We're also going to be using some simple sugar, so sugar syrup. There is a video as well. I'll get Will to place it somewhere on screen or in the comment box down below where you can learn how to make this at home. We've said before, don't buy a sugar syrup. It's a waste of money. If you are going to be making smaller quantities at home, you can just make a super easy simple syrup, you know, 200 ml, 300 ml, whatever you need to get you through the day. But they last about 3 to 5 days in the fridge, so good to make in advance. That's it, that's all the ingredients. So again, you know, what's that? It's five ingredients. We're gonna be shaking it all except for this. We're gonna be using this to top it up with at the end. Straining a long glass. I've gone for like a lovely craft beer glass. I think it looks really, really, pretty inside of that when we garnish it with the pink grapefruit as well. But feel free if you've only got like a tall Collins or even a wine glass, you know, feel like experiment. Use whatever glass you have at home and you have the most of if you are having a party. There really is no kind of limits to what you can use. I would say, because it is a long drink, you're gonna wanna add ice to it. So make sure it has got volume for all of that, not like a martini glass or something. But yeah, let's just jump straight into it. So shaker, and then we're gonna grab our tequila. So because this is the only spirit we're gonna be using, we're gonna use a nice hefty amount. So standard, I'd always use if it is a single spirit, around 50 mil. So we'll just go with that for the moment. So 50 mil of lovely Ocho tequila, and then pink grapefruit juice. We're just gonna do 25 mil. Fresh lime, again, 25 mil. And then sugar syrup. I'm probably gonna add 10 mil. You can up it a little bit if you want, if you like it a little bit more sweeter. I don't like sweet cocktails. I prefer bitter, sour, sharp, citrusy. So I'm just gonna go for 10 mil, which I'll find is perfect for me. And that's it. That's everything in the shaker that we need to shake. So we're just gonna pop some ice straight in, give it a good tap, make sure it doesn't come loose, and then in good shape. So yeah, this is, again, a perfect drink for summer. I think tequila is becoming a really, what's the word, kind of like a popular spirit, and rightly so. You know, I think gin, Prosecco, wine have all had its times to shine. There seems to be, well, I'm seeing a lot of it. I don't know if it's just because I'm paying attention more, because I really like tequila at the moment, but I'm seeing a lot more distilleries, types of tequila, mezcal, all those types of products popping up a lot more. I think it's doing wonders for Mexico. And yeah, it's good to see some unusual spirits that probably wouldn't appeal to a lot more people becoming more popular and having their rightful moment shine. So I'm all for that. I like that. So we're gonna fill up our glass with ice. We're just gonna single strain, because it doesn't matter if we get a few shards of ice in. So I'm gonna fill it up to about there. There's a little bit more left in there, so maybe get a larger glass if you have one, but if you don't, you can just quickly shot that before you serve it to your guests or something. That's what I'm gonna do, don't tell anyone. And then, yep, pink grapefruit soda. I'm literally messing up all my citruses today. Pink grapefruit soda. We're just gonna top it up to give it a little bit of bubbles, help lengthen the drink. And then get a nice fresh pink grapefruit. And then we're just gonna chop a nice wedge off for a garnish and for added citrus if they would like it. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Super easy tequila cocktail. Paloma, really refreshing, long-based summer drink, perfect for hot weathers, and enjoying with friends. Cheers. I'm not sharing this one either. Should we move to Mexico? Let's do it.